while you were busy taking down that fort, I happened to stumble upon the treasury.
You don't say.
It was the damnedest thing. in any case, amongst other things, I found maps and charts detailing various French trade routes.
What are you thinking?
Thank you.
Colonel thanks and congratulates you, Shay. He has returned to New York. But you look troubled.
Do you ever wonder if you're doing the right thing, Gist? If you chose the right path?
I used to, my young friend, but not anymore. Not since I met the Colonel. And what's the question? The French are entrenched in our territory. It's about time we root them out.
Of course. You're right, Gist. Let's head back to New York.
Aye, Captain.
The wind blows!
Foul weather there, Captain!
Cargo adrift, Captain!
Short sail! Get off the squall! All right, man. Sink!
Safe and sound at home again. Let the waters roar, Jack. Safe and sound at home again. Let the waters roar, Jack.
Long we tossed on a rolling main. Now we're safe ashore, Jack. Don't forget your old shipmate. Body, 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 body.
Tops, gallants, royals, studs!
Don't we pass on the rolling plain? Now we're safe ashore, Jack! Don't forget your old shipmate! Rolly, 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 rolly!
Could be valuable cargo!
The self-same gun, quarter deck divisions, and cross under high and low to you!
He's off the way! Let's move!
He's got teeth, Captain!
Ships from a wreck may over
come
here,
and ships may go as long as the seas do roll. But a sailor lad just like his dad, he loves
trip the yards off the wind!
A woman ashore, he has a door. A girl who's plump and round. When your money's all gone, it's the same old song. Get up, Jack John, sit down.
Hey. Come along, you jolly brave boys. There's plenty more grog in the jar. We'll plow the briny ocean line.
As much sail as you can!
When Jack's ashore, he'll make his way to some old boarding house. He's welcomed in with rum and gin, likewise with pork and scouse. He'll spend and never offend till he lies drunk on the ground. When his money's all gone, it's the same old song. Get up, Jack John, sit down.
Come along, the jolly way forward. There's plenty more grog in the jar. We'll plow the briny.
Some ship bound for India or Japan. In Asia, there the ladies fare. Oh, love a sailor man. He'll go ashore and he'll not scorn to buy some girl or gun. When his money's all gone, it's the same old song.
Get up, Jack John, sits down. Come along, we jolly brave boys. There's plenty more grog in the jar. We'll plow the briny ocean like a jolly rover.
Douse the gallants and boys.
Jack is one. Too old to cruise about. They'll let him stop in some rum shop till eight bells calls him out. Then he'll raise hands high and
loose all the trip sharp to the wind.
Homeward now. When his money's all gone, it's the same old song. Get up, Jack John, sit down.
Come along, my jolly brave boys. There's plenty more grog in the jar. We'll plow the briny ocean like
keep ahead, sir.
Come along, come.
What in God's name are you doing? Guards!
Everywhere.
Keep your brown best.
Not done here, Smith.
Ah, Master Cormac. What you have learned from Le Chasseur was confirmed. The local lawbreakers are changing tactics.
What's their plan now?
Their boss has hired Benjamin Franklin to produce new weapons for them. He's very well guarded.
Benjamin Franklin? The scientist?
You have heard of him. Good. He is making equipment to spread gases among the populace. Toxic ones, as it turns out.
The populace? I thought they would use it against the authorities. Though that would be terrible as well.
The ruffians we have arrested refer to an intimidating woman. I believe she is behind these nefarious plans.
I look into this.
Thank you.
Hope. I pray it's not you.
Shay, it is good to see you again. Your friend Hope said you were away.
I was. Sir, I've come to collect the results of your experiments.
Oh, well, it's a very good thing then. I just finished fixing the prototype. Here you go. I was preparing to leave for Philadelphia, and then Europe. I was invited to lecture in London. Oh, would you be so kind as to inform Mistress Hope?
Of course. God, Hope. What are you doing with these felons? Turning the city against itself. What have you become?
Something the matter, Master Cormac?
No. Yes, just old memories.
When I am issued new recruits burdened with regrets, I tell them the surest way to lose them is with gunpowder.
You're right, Colonel.
This prototype seems very powerful. Use it with care, Master Cormac. Our intelligence says this thing can destroy certain fortifications, as well as injure several enemies at once. There is also a more subtle way to use it. Some of these grenades contain a strong sedative. Fire one into the crowd and they will fall asleep immediately. We should test this new weapon. Use it against that door. Go ahead, Master Cormac. Shoot the door. Use these grenades to... Good work. I think you are ready to turn this new weapon against the ruffians who would have used it. There is an abandoned factory nearby hiding a dangerous poison. Right now, it only causes sleep. But I fear those outlaws are distilling it. A more powerful formula could sicken or perhaps even kill most of New York.
Then that's my first target.
Be careful, Master Cormac. We understand that the ingredients are highly unstable.
All the better.
To look a little more respectable.
If I mess with this, maybe I can break the whole system.
You there! Come over here.
Oi! Couldn't you have had the decency to go on someone else's turn.
Must get out, or I'm as good as dead.
What marvelous destruction, Captain. I saw the smoke all the way from the Morrigan.
That should discourage those miscreants. New York is safe for now.
With all due respect, Colonel, it's going to take more than a few explosions to get rid of this kind of trouble.
The boy is right, Colonel Monroe.
Shay, was it? Congratulations. You just burned a whole lot of rats out of New York. I'm Jack Weeks. This is William Johnson. I don't know about him, but I'm pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
It is terribly dusty here. I'm sure Shay can recount his adventures to us over a pint. Hey, the first round's on the Colonel.
Huh? Something the matter, Master Cormac?
Just a little confused. I must have breathed some of that gas.
Some ale will do you good. Come, we are all friends here. You will be taken care of.
Colonel.
Dear Master Cormac, my apologies for the brevity of this missive, but it is time we were honest with one another. You have demonstrated your loyalty and resourcefulness to the Templar cause, and this despite and perhaps because of your assassin origins. The manuscript the assassin sought has been in my possession for some time. I reclaimed it when my men found you marooned. The Grandmaster himself charged me to discover its meaning, a task I regret I have failed to complete. I leave it in your charge, Master Cormac. There is no one else I trust more. Now I leave for Fort William Henry, an ill-prepared garrison surrounded by hostile natives and the French army. We have requested reinforcements, but I doubt they will be forthcoming. I have no illusions that our resistance will be successful. I commit my life to the British Army, and my soul to the Father of Understanding. Yours, Colonel George Monroe.
Captain has the helm!
Mind your post, guest. The Colonel's in trouble.
How do you mean, in trouble?
He's at Fort William Henry, facing impossible odds.
Get off your lazy asses, lads, and man your stations! We raise anchor!
Sorry for the early libation, Captain. But do you realize that it's been a whole year since we met? A whole year! Changed my life, you did. And for the better. You will forgive me if I have been celebrating without you.
A whole year. Yes, I have a question for you. How long have you known of my, well, former allegiance?
Oh, you mean the assassins? I knew...
Just a gaucher. I may be drunk, but I'm not blind. Or did you think I would assume you had escaped from some homicidal circus?
Why didn't you say anything?
Well, the Colonel wanted us to avoid the subject so it wouldn't, you know, influence your decision-making. You saved my life out of pure selfless instinct and helped countless others besides. If it were up to me, I would have made you an official Templar months ago.
Who is it up to, then? Monroe mentioned a Grand Master.
Oh, yes. The Grand Master of the Colonial Rite. You'd like him, Shay. His father was an assassin.
Really? He must have a story to tell.
What is the news from Fort William Henry?
The garrison is surrounded, and reinforcements are late.
General Montcalm has been blazing a path across the colonies for King Louis, hasn't he?
I rather wish he'd stayed home with his mistress.
His or King Louis's?
Either, though I suspect the King's is finer.
Indeed. Madame O'Murphy is supposed to be quite the charmer.
And O'Murphy is in the French King's bed. Now I know you're pulling my leg.
Ready, boys? It's a damn tough land. I walked down on Broadway one evening in July. I met a mate who asked me trade and a sailor shot. Said I, it's the way you send in, my dear Annie. Oh, you New York girl, can't you dance the polka? To Tiffany's I took her. I
some cargo from the wreck over here, sir.
I bought a two-gold earring, and they cost me 15 cents. And it's the way you send it, my dear Annie. Oh, you New York girls, can't you dance the polka? Said she, yet I'm too sailor. Now see me home, you may. But when we reached her cottage door, she unto me did say, and it's the way you send it, my dear Annie. Oh, you New York girls, can't you dance the polka? My flashman, he's a Yankee, with his hair cut short behind. He wears a pair of long sea boots, he's a bosun in the backboard.
Flash it low! Wide, white the snow!
Dark skies and rough seas there!
Fire!
You heard the captain! Move!
Hostile water!
Fire!
Scars all but made!
Reef the foremain! Hull of the vessel!
For sail! All sail!
Get out of range or they'll sink us!
Hammered us that time!
Crowd on every inch of sail!
Loose topsails, gallants and royals! As we were fishing off Hayes Broad Line, shooting and hauling and trolling all night in that windy old weather. Stormy old weather, when the wind blows, we'll all hold together. When up jumped a herring, the queen of the sea, says now, old skipper, you cannot catch me. In the windy old weather,
stormy old weather. When the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
We sigh to the thrasher, a slash in his tail. Time now, old skipper, to hoist up your sail.
In the windy old weather, stormy old weather. When the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
And up jumps a slipsail as strong as a horse. Says now, old skipper, you're miles off course.
In the windy old weather,
flotsam, sir. Could be valuable cargo.
When the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
Then along comes a place who's got spots on his side. Says not much longer, he sees you can ride.
Brief in our
tops! Stormy old weather, stormy old weather. When the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
And up is a conger as long as a mile. Winds come in easily, he says with a smile.
In the windy old weather, stormy old weather, when the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
I think what that these fishes are saying is right. We'll haul up our gear now and steer for the light.
In the windy old weather, stormy old weather, when the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
Fall down and clue up!
Venture away!
Que tout reste exactement tel quel.
Tu es du genre autoritaire, toi.
J'ai besoin d'un coup de main pour fermer la porte.
And now!
toi, Jean Rouge.
Arrête. Je veux te parler. That'll do. And how.
Genre, je pense que c'est...
J'ai une dette envers vous. Merci.
Spread our wings to the wind!
Loose sails! Let's catch the wind!
He will get your fate, and it's time for us to leave her. Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. For the voyage is long, and the winds don't blow, and it's time for us to leave her. Oh, the wind was foul, and the sea ran high. Leave her, Johnny, leave her. She shipped it green, and none went by, and it's time for us to leave her. Leave her, Johnny, leave her. Oh, leave her, Johnny, leave her. For the voyage is long, and the winds don't blow, and it's time for us to leave her. I hate to sail on this rotten tub. Leave her, Johnny, leave her.
That's quite a wind, Captain!
Topsails and gallants.
Well, our anchor's on board.
All right, fine now.
We're on course to hit rocks, sir.
Anchor ahoy!